Hello YouTube, I'm Quantum Fear and welcome to my walkthrough of Batman Arkham Asylum. This is the first of two videos to show how to go through the area of the Arkham Mansion. We start the video after we have gotten out of the caves and into Arkham Island East. And we find ourselves facing four snipers and having to find our way past them and into the mansion. Okay, so once you go through the door, it immediately tells you that there's snipers in the area. The quickest way I find is you take out the first two by grabbing up the closest one. The snipers in general you are okay with as long as you don't make a ton of noise and you're on the same level with them. If you try to do that in the lower with their scanners and night vision goggles, they see you pretty quick and they can hurt you pretty bad. So just try to find your way to the top of the mansion. And I could have jumped from here, but I decided not to. But trying to find your way to the top of the mansion, and you can kind of swoop your way down and around and engage the two snipers that are occupying the balcony where you need to enter. If you're going to do hand-to-hand with the snipers, what you really want to make sure is that you keep them both busy at the same time. Here, I do get shot, but quickly throw a batarang or yank him towards you with a grapple and take him out as fast as you can. With those sniper rifles, they can do a lot of damage very fast. After you get these guys done and you don't have anything else you want to do in this area, just zap onto the grate and work your way in. Fight the furthest guy has a gun. It's best to take him out quickly because, again, the guns cause more damage than anything else that other people can do. And in general, it's an easy fight, so you really shouldn't need to worry as long as you take him out first. The bad guys can and do pick up the guns every so often if they're left to their own devices, so just work your way through quickly. You'll find that door locked, and you'll just want to go up to the air vent, and you're going to go through there. And through the breakable wall, making sure to grab the Arkham Spirit. And then you have this is probably the first big group fight you come across with more than five guys. You can, if you, by the way, drop down and take him out silently. I just didn't that time. And with big groups like this, you want to make sure to always stay moving. Don't let them get around you. The jumping, if you can just... You don't like countering, just jump over them when you see them. You see the blue, you don't have to jump over the people that are about to hit you, just jump away, and they generally will miss you. And just, you know, when you get a chance, use your takedown effects. You can also use the throat and just throw them right into your other opponents. I actually do particularly good at this fight, managing one long free flow, which isn't always easy, considering with a big group like this, it's easy for one of them to whack you. Although, another handy thing to remember is that when you're doing your takedowns, the bad guys will not come after you. They'll get around you, but they won't hit you, so you feel free to do it whenever, even in the middle of a massive group. From here, just grab the Gordon picture, the Riddler and underneath the statue, and the Arkham and at the very top of the bell tower. Not to mention the interview tape and the three Joker teeth. There's a lot of stuff here. Now this, I ran back to this part. You don't actually have to do this right here. You can actually wait until after you've done the other wing of the mansion, thus not having to come back here twice. But I just happened to do it this time, because that's the way the storyline flows. But you can skip this area pretty well pretty exact. So yeah, just get those teeth, get line up the question mark here, and grab the other spirit. And around the corner is two more bad guys, one with a gun. Just take him out quickly with a batarang. And when you enter the room, you get a fight with a library with two knife wielders, which makes it tricky. But always remember, try to take out the knife wielders with your takedown effects, because they cannot block them, and it's the quickest way to get them down. You're done with that room, just grab that question mark and then work your way to the bottom, where the Joker once again throws a little wrench in your plans and makes you have to run back up. You get to the top of the stairs and then just grapple to your way as high as you can go and find the duct and work your way through the air ducts until you get to the above the chandelier, where you cut it, and then the chandelier drops through the glass below and you can rescue them. It says there's a time limit, but I am not positive that there is one, so I don't know how much you really have to worry. And once you're done with that, all you got to do is go back up to where the chandelier was, and there is actually a crawl space where you can get another Riddler question mark. And here... once you're done there, you just drop back up to the middle one and leave the library. Just leave the library and work your way back to the other wing of the mansion, grabbing any of those clues and taking out these guys that you happen to miss. The guy through the door, you don't have to do this, but I'm pretty sure he's armed. So I find the best way to deal with him is just to sneak up behind him and take him out with a silent chokehold like that. They describe the callers to you and what they do, and then you enter in this next stealth challenge. Now this first guy, you can actually also zip up to the banister and just bang his head against the railing, also so you don't have to do it this way. Again, I just happen to like the inverted takedowns quite a lot. And those corner ones, those corner gargoyles, are not actually over anything, so there is in fact no way you can the invert takedown anybody from there. Now the callers add a whole new thing to it, where even if you do a silent takedown, the bad guys will know that someone's missing and they'll come running. You end up using this technology with in one of your batarangs, making kind of a lure that you throw the batarang and it makes one of them come to wherever you threw the batarang. So it does come in hand, and you can also use that to plant other attacks where you take out somebody and then force someone else to come check on it when you take them out at the same time. Come on. Right here, I'm just looking for an opening. I don't spend a lot of time on the ground. You can obviously do this faster if you... I mean, obviously you can do it faster. I just happen to do it this way. because I like the idea of pouncing on them from so high up. See, this is the sonic battery, which is the lure. You just throw it to where you want them to go. You have to be careful though, because sometimes they do have to be close enough to hear it. They don't always, and if they're really far away, they may not hear it. Now what this guy did is he actually saw the batarang before he got underneath me, and he just said, "This is one of my this is one of Batman's toys," and to like, what the hell? So I got to take him out quickly. I missed my first batarang, but then just go for the kill there. I could have also dropped down and used the grapple to take him to yank him over the edge, which is that's very entertaining to do. I find.
Is someone missing? I keep losing
count. I do not know how transparent the walkways are. Now, I take out this guy, and then that is the end of this video. Subscribe if you like this. I will see you guys in the next part of this video, of this level.